that also controls the and the right pilot. Now, looking out the left and right side of the canopy of the airplane, he looks at the horizon where the water meets the sky out to the east and where the land meets the sky out to the west. A roll rate of 400 degrees per second in a modified Lycoming engine, turning out 400 horsepower. It is the Textron Lycoming 540 engine. On the front to absorb that horsepower is a German MT high-tech propeller. The Viper is a one-of-a-kind biplane. There is no other like it in the world because it is Jason Newbert that put all the modifications into the airplane. Now pulling out a hard left turn into the positive G environment and then immediately into the negative G environment. What does that mean? Positive G's are the ones that squish you down into your seat. Negative G environments are the ones that try to lift you out of your seat and separate you from the seat of your airplane and put your head up to the clear plexiglass canopy. But those Hooker custom harnesses, you ratchet those down so tight it hurts. Then you take a deep breath. Then you exhale and you tighten those shoulder harnesses and lap belts even more. You do not want to float out under that seat. All right, bringing the Viper finally down on the deck. The only special is the flying on the side of the fuselage. And now, Jason Newberg, out of that knife-edge flight, is going to do a little bit of climbing, and we will go to the cockpit now and talk to Jason Newberg as he takes just a little rest. Jason is standing on the ground. What a beautiful day. How's it feel to you, Jason Newberg?
What a great day to fly. So the air is nice and thick. You can see that smoke just standing still. Not a lot of wind. Could not ask for a better day, Danny. I want to just get on the mic real quick. I don't want to interrupt the performance for too long, but I wanted to thank all the organizers. Thank you, the city of Daytona, and especially in Brazil. What a great aviation community and aviation town Daytona is. I'm going to get back to work, and thanks everybody for coming out. Enjoy the day. What a great day it is.
All right, that was direct from the cockpit. Calm, cool, and collected. He's a pretty cool guy. All right, the smoke is on. That means watch me. Picking up a little bit of what Bob Hooper calls the insurance policy, and that is altitude. And now, to get the entry speed to his next maneuver, he uses that altitude to dive down to the maximum redline speed of the aircraft. And then a pullback on the control stick, the G-forces. 5 times the normal force of gravity as he arcs the aircraft around in 5/8 of a loop and then starts a rapid roll series on the 45-degree down line in relation to the horizon. Depth perception over the water is a challenge as well. Now Jason pulls to the vertical again, starts that up vertical roll at a speed of over 200 miles per hour, dissipating to 100 to 50, 40, 30, 20, 10, 0. And now let's disappear, Jason. Roll backwards, 50, 60 miles an hour, a little bit of sky magic, and he's up the bottom side. A big round of applause for Jason Newbert. A little bit of sky magic. Into the history.
Nice, man.
Now you watch the Jason Newbert, like all of our professionals, Jason sponsored by Oakley Sunglasses, will use our sky stage, the area in front of the hotel, as a place to be able to always be back in front of the crowd. There is the spin that was thought to be unrecoverable at one time. They call it the death spin. It was said to be Eddie Stinson, who instead of fighting the airplane, just gave in. Instead of trying to pull the control stick back, he pushed it towards the earth. He said, I got nothing to lose. You know what happened? He got speed. The wing continued to fly, and he was the first man, it has been written, to come out of a maneuver like this. To spin at air show center. Push the stick forward, go with the flow, much like we do to have success in life. Just go with the flow and don't fight it. A big correlation between the spin and life's trials and tribulations. All right, now to the negative G environment, immediately and without rest. And even though he's sitting down, this is pain and punishment. We talk to you about the world of positive and negative G Jason Newberg, sponsored by Oakley, is hanging upside down. He's turning upside down. Now he's rolling right side up. And now it's Sky C, Sky C, Sky C. Immediately, then pulling back on the stick. And even though Jason Newberg is sitting in a seat in the cockpit, this is no free ride. You know what they say about G's? G's, that hurts. There's pain in G's. It's discomforting. Here's punishment. These 10, 12, and 15-minute routines of these pilots are the equivalent of about 8 hours of intense physical labor. And yes, conditioning, both physical and mental, are very important to increase your G-tolerance. The one-of-a-kind pain scheme, filling up the sky, Jason Newberg, yet another proud individual from every rental, will continue. Putting the main gear right down on that spray. Oakley sunglasses, Creed, and a world-class athlete who see the limits of possibility as just another challenge. And Oakley blends science and art to redefine product categories by rejecting the constraints of convention.
diagram shows you just how exceptional the F-16 is in a 9G turn. At show center, he will bank sharply and accelerate through a tight turn, pressing into the seat with a force of up to 9 times his normal weight. In the full turn, the Viper has a turn radius of less than 1,400 feet.
How can you see into